Hello, and welcome back, everyone. Our journey is coming close to an end because we are jumping into what I believe will be the final paint before the reveal of our repaint of this figure. And you guessed it, we're going to go with some Citadel Agrax Earthshade. You know, if you followed other videos, you know this is one of my favorites. And when it comes to dirt and grime and creating that natural earthy effect, Agrax Earthshade is absolutely phenomenal. And one of the amazing things about Agrax is that it will react to what you have done underneath in your base and your dry in your base coats and your dry brushing coats. It will play off of what you have already done. So we're just going to get right into it, and I'm going to go over top of these orange pants that I have toned down tremendously from what they were originally. And the reason for that is so I knew going into this that I was going to be using Agrax. And I'm going to let it get on before I start pulling it off, because I don't want that much darkness and depth. I want depth, I just don't want that much. But I need to get it on so that it can start to do its magic. And the way that I'll be taking this off is with a brush. There are other methods where you can use a sponge, you can use a Q-tip, and those methods are absolutely perfectly fine. I think they have perfect time and place. And I, for one, I just prefer to use my brush. I've done it enough times, and I'm content with how that turns out. So, all right, I've got it on the surface. I'm gonna pull this cape out of the way. And now what I'm gonna do, move so you can see better. I'm gonna take my brush that I've pulled out the excess into the lid, and now I'm going to pull it off. Go back to the top of the lid. It has a nice little edge for me to. I'm just going to pull that off. Pull that off. Don't need it to be that deep. Now, around the tops of the boot, I'm going to hit that surface. All right. And now, with as very little on my brush as possible, I'm going to go through this boot. And I'm only going to just. I'm gonna go quick. So, apologize in advance for how quick I'm going, but that is the name of the game here. The more you linger, the more depth that you actually lose, and it just becomes more of a consistent application, and that is not what we're going for here. So, all right, going back through, pulling out. There we go. Legs are. Gonna go through again, pull out that excess. All right, those should be set. All right, now around the, I won't call it gauntlets, but around this fabric, I'm gonna go in and pull out the excess. And now I'm just gonna go through again quickly and lightly. Don't need a ton there, because if I put a ton, I'm going to completely negate all of the impact that I've done with my dry brushing on those parts. And up here on the arms and the sleeves, I'm not even going to touch them. Don't even going to touch them. Now around the waist, I am. I'm just going to follow this, almost looks like a cummerbund. Just going to go right through there and hit that. And that's going to give us some depth there. And right there, make sure I've got enough on my brush. And go through again. There we go. Perfect. Okay. And as far as that utility belt, I'm literally going to tap in and I'm going to be starting to touch just those recessed areas. Really don't need to do a ton here. Because again, the more that I put on, the more that I will be just hiding the efforts that I've put into this. Now the belt buckle, I am going to hit that one just a little bit more. So the center belt buckle. And there's one on the side. I'm just going to touch that. All right. Good. And in the recesses of the harness here, I'm just going to go real light right there. There's a deep area there, deep area there. I'm not swiping, I'm literally jabbing at this point because I do not want to completely cover. Jab, 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 jab in between each one of these. Right there, just enough. Give it some dynamic depth. So here we go. I'm going to let that dry and feeling fairly confident that what I've put on is actually going to be it and be finished. So I can move that off to the side and I'm going to pick up this weapon real quick and I'm just going to hit a couple things. Again, moving my brush really nice and light. The entire shaft here, I'm really going to let that be pretty much as is, but when we get into some of these nooks and crannies and crevices in here, I'm going to get that brush in there, and we're just going to get in there, again, there's a crevice, just to give this some depth, brush, and through, and the nice thing about, again, thin layers and not going super heavy is if you decide you want to go back through and add, you certainly can. It's way easier to add than to try to come back and say, oh, I wish I wouldn't have put so much on there and I should have went lighter. A lot easier to put things on as compared to taking them off. I'm actually really happy with how that's looking right now there so far. Up here, I'm good with that. Yeah, I'll grab that backpack. I've done a couple other little kind of details here off camera. With super fine details where I'm just absolutely focused. And there's a well right there that I'm just going to kind of hit that. And then in between these canisters or whatever they are, I'm going to give a little swipe. Rotate, even though you can't see that side, I'm going to hit that, do a flip, do the underside, get those, and that's good. Just kind of set that there, and with the helmet, I am just going to, again with the orange, just going to touch, back of the helmet, and rotate, we'll come to the front. And just really super light. I'll be taking off the majority of this. Again, the reason for that is I do not want that to just become a just total waste. I want to create depth, but I do not want it to be just so solid. Yeah, that, okay, well. Apparently, what I put on was just the right amount because I am really digging that. Okay, well, hooray for happy accidents. So, all right, so I think we're set. Love this dry. Come back to it. Look at it. If there's anything else, I'll make another video. But otherwise, I look forward to seeing you in the reveal. Thanks.